So let's talk about ideal pitch rates in beer. Now, I'm gonna rattle off some information here, and don't get hung up on all the numbers. We'll explain a little bit more. Your ideal pitch rate is 0.75 to 1.5 million yeast cells per milliliter of wort per degree Play-Doh. All right, stop writing. You don't need to write all of those numbers down. All I want you to take out of this is that as you increase your volume of beer you're making or your gravity changes, that's gonna change the amount of yeast that is ideal to get the flavor profiles that you're looking for. If you get more or less, it will change those flavor profiles that the yeast produce and potentially add other challenges later in your brew day. Let's think of ideal pitch rate this way. Imagine you go to a buffet with you and 10 of your best friends, and they lock the door and say, you guys can't leave until you eat all this food. Now imagine if you go to that same buffet with you and 200 friends, and they lock the door and say, you can't leave until you eat all this food. The second is gonna be a little bit more of an enjoyable experience. Everything we do as brewers is to make our yeast happy. There's a fun saying, brewers make wort and yeast make beer. And having the ideal pitch rate gives the yeast the best chance to make the best beer that you want. So when I'm looking at most beers that I make, I just go right in the middle of that ideal pitch rate. That's 1 million yeast cells per milliliter of wort per degree Play-Doh. So 1 million yeast cells times the number of milliliters. Now, if you don't know how many milliliters are in a 5-gallon batch, it's 18,927, and that's just common knowledge. If you didn't know that coming into this, I don't think you should take the rest of the course. Jokes, jokes. It's around 19 liters, so 19,000. So 1 million yeast cells times 19,000 times degrees Play-Doh. Now, for a lot of people, that may be a new term, degrees Play-Doh, but it's just a different way of thinking of your gravity. It's a different scale to measure your gravity. It's similar to that of bricks. So if you have a refractometer, you'll have two scales, one with your specific gravity and one with bricks. Most professional brewers, most commercial breweries use Play-Doh when they're measuring the gravity of their beer instead of specific gravity. There's a really easy conversion, and while this isn't perfectly linear, it will get you right in the area that you need to be. If you take the numbers to the right of the decimal of your specific gravity and divide that by 4, that will be your degrees Play-Doh. For example, if we're at a 1060, 1.060, you look at the number to the right of the decimal, which is 60, 60 divided by 4 is 15. That's 15 degrees Play-Doh. If you're at a 1040, 1.040, again, 40 divided by 4 is 10, 10 degrees Play-Doh. So let's recap that quick. 1 million yeast cells times your milliliters of wort, 19,000, times your degree Play-Doh. So if a 1060, that'd be 15. So it'd be 1 million times 19,000 times 15. And that's gonna give you your ideal pitch rate. Now I'm not gonna do that in my head. Hold on. I have a calculator. So if I go 1 times 19,000 times, in this case with a gravity of 1060, 15 degrees Play-Doh, that is 285 billion yeast cells. And that's just a quick calculation. If you guys got 285, then you followed my math and there's still hope for me as a math teacher. I'm not a math teacher. This is a lot of numbers that I'm throwing right now. So pause and breathe for a second. Okay. The biggest thing that I want you to take out of this is that often you're not adding enough yeast and you need to add more. And that how much yeast you need to add depends on your gravity and the volume of beer you're making. If you take that out, don't get hung up in the formula. Don't get hung up on the calculation. There are plenty of calculators online that can tell you that exact number so you don't have to pull out your phone and figure out that it's 285 billion cells. More importantly is if you have a beer, say an IPA that's got a gravity of 1064, and you're looking at adding one pack of yeast, that likely is not enough yeast for that beer, with most manufacturers being somewhere between 100 to 200 billion yeast cells per pack. You need to look at adding more yeast cells to that to come out with the beer at the quality you're looking for. Again, this is how we make better beer. A lot of information, so let's pause and great. In the next section, we're gonna talk about what happens if you over or under pitch your beer. So we'll talk about a little bit too much or too little and what that might do.